later on.
Regis, I just want you to know how much we enjoy your show here. And I have a question about Kathie Lee.
About who?
About Kathie.
Yes.
Is she as sensitive as she appears to be on your show?
Kathie Lee sensitive? Well, to what?
To everything. I mean, she's so aware of everything, and she seems to show such empathy to anybody who's suffering or, you know, any episode you all have on your show about abused children or anything. She seems so...
Well, you know, I think she is. How many times has she broken down and cried right on the show?
That's what I'm talking about.
Yeah, it's... she really is a very sensitive person, and it shows. She wears it right on her sleeve, and sometimes it catches me by surprise, you know. For example, remember the Mother's Day show we did?
Oh, my gosh, I sat and cried with y'all, yeah.
Well, that, I guess, you provoked a lot of tears, but she cried with every different mother that came out.
I know. It was a good
show. It was a veil of tears, Milton.
Well, listen, Regis, can you, my mom is sitting at home listening to this. Can you say hi to Kitty?
Kitty, how are you? Happy Mother's Day, Kitty.
Thank you, Lana.
Mother's Day all over again on the Milton Metz Show.
That's right. Regis, you take care.
Thanks.
Bye-bye.
Thank
Bye-bye.
You. It's 22 minutes to 10 o'clock. We're here with Regis Philbin, and we will continue after this brief timeout from 84 WHS.
Investment tips for the 90s. Sell things you don't own.
Oh, sure. The Hoover Dam has been in my family for years.
Dabble in valuable works of art.
No kidding. Van Gogh painted on black velvet?
Or buy a selected Whirlpool clean top or gas range now. During Whirlpool's Real American Cashback Sale, you'll be investing in a range solidly built to last for years and get up to $100 cash back right now.
$100? I could buy a dozen Van Goghs.
I got a dam here.
Whirlpool's Real American Cashback Sale. See a participating dealer for details.
Do you know there are only 44 sounds in the English language? 44. And when you learn these 44 sounds called phonics, you can read and spell almost everything. That's why Hooked on Phonics is so successful. We've set these 44 sounds to music, making learning to read simple and fun. So get Hooked on Phonics and take the mystery out of learning to read. Call 1-800-ABCDEFG.
We're back with Regis Philbin. I'm Milton Metz on our nightly phone-in show. Hello, Bob. You're on.
Yes, Mr. Metz. I have a comment. I was on vacation last week, and unfortunately, this was the first time I've been able to see Regis. I wish I could see him every day, but I have to go to work a little bit earlier. But he had a program where they had the skin cancer, and I was very impressed by it. And I would, I have called a number because I believe I have skin cancer in certain parts, and I have called it, and I would like the Louisville area to know that the cancer screen will be held at the Kentucky State Fair.
Very good.
And if this is any compliment to the man, I'm appreciative of it.
Well, Bob, thanks very much. You know, I've heard from quite a few people who have been alerted. Every now and then we have this dermatologist on the show, and we go over all the things you should do and shouldn't be doing. And frankly, I've received some touching letters about people who caught it on the show, checked into their own situation, and saved their own lives. And I wish you the best, and I'm glad that we could help.
Okay.
Thank you, sir.
Be a part of the show.
Okay, Bob. Thanks very much.
Hello, Laurie.
Hi, Regis.
Hi, Laurie. How you doing?
I'm fine. I just love your show.
Well, thanks, Laurie.
I watch it every day, and I was wondering if you guys give Gelman such a hard time sometimes, and I wondered if when the camera wasn't on, if that upsets him.
No, then we really give him a hard time when the camera's not on. Now, Gelman, you know, I don't know, one day something came up, and I needed an answer right then and there, and there was Gelman standing there, so I asked him, and a little exchange happened, and we got a laugh, and I said, well, now that's a little safety valve for me. So I kept going back to him and raising the heck with him. He's a fine young guy. He's been with me since he got out of college. He came here as an intern.
Is that right?
Yeah, and started at the bottom, you know, just running around answering mail and answering phones, and then got a job as a production assistant and worked his way up the ladder. And then I let him produce my cable show back in the last part of the 80s. And Then he did 6 months on Hollywood Squares, and then when my producer left to do another show, I insisted that they hire Gilman. He was the last one here. You know, all my producers are gone now. Two of them are producing Geraldo. Mm-hmm. One is producing Joan Rivers. One is producing Rick Dees. And one is producing Arsenio Hall.
Is that right?
All of these kids I taught myself. And Gilman was the last one here. And so Gilman inherited the job. And frankly, I think he's the best I've had.
And this is really... This program is really an expression of Regis Philbin.
Well, yeah. You know, I mean, I've kind of created it, and the tempo and the kind of guests after my own, you know, likes. And so it is a reflection of me. But they learn how to do it, and they learn what's funny and what isn't, and then they go on to other jobs. And I'm kind of proud to say that all of these kids are now doing very well producing other people's shows.
Laurie, thank you very much.
Thanks, Laurie.
Thank you. Bye-bye.
You know, is it unusual? This was a big hit on WABC TV, local in New York, right?
Yes.
Which, of course, is a big enough audience for, you know, half the country. But do they own it with you?
Well, here's how it works. They own the show. Walt Disney Studios came in under their Buena Vista syndication wing and decided they wanted to syndicate it. So they buy the show from WABC TV.
I see.
And WABC owns it. I own it to the point where I will share in the profits.
Right.
Now, Milton, here's another scoop for you. The show's been on the air 3 years.
Right.
Do I have to tell you that there are no net profits so far?
Yeah, the Hollywood bookkeeping?
You got it.
I can't believe it. You're on what?
Haven't made a dime on this show since it's been on, Milton.
I just got through reading the book, You'll Never Have Lunch in This Town Again.
Yeah.
You know that book by...
Sure, Julia Phillips.
Julia Phillips. I've heard about that. A film makes $150 million, and they say, well, we haven't gone into the black yet.
They advertise it around so much that you don't know what's going on, but... I signed a deal, and so did Kathy, that we would get a little piece of the net profits. Well, there are no net profits.
But you're on a, what, 180-plus station?
Yeah. You figure it out. You say, do I own it? Well, yeah, I own some net profits, but so far, there haven't been any net profits.
I'm going to send my bookkeeper up to you.
Okay, I can use them.
Right. 10:15. Hello, Faye. Regis is here.
Hello there, Regis.
Hi, Faye. How you doing?
We're a retired couple, and we enjoy your show every morning while we have breakfast or afterwards. And we just enjoy seeing the New York newspapers, the headlines, what's going on in the Big Apple, you know, down here in the heartland where we are.
Oh, well, that's good. I'm glad. Milton said that he enjoyed it, too.
Yeah, we really do. It just keeps us up with the world and what's going on, and we enjoy all the... talking you and Kathie Lee do and hearing about Cody and my husband says he's waiting for you both to take off someday and Frank and Joy to do the show.
Well, you know, we have thought about that. Joy does it when Kathy's on vacation. Unfortunately,
She's very good.
I do. I just get 6 weeks. She gets 10, and the other four Joy does. And so what they do is repeat Kathy and my show for the six that I'm gone.
Mm-hmm. Well,
who knows? One day that might happen.
That might happen. Well,
I think you and Milton should do the show.
Keep going. We enjoy it.
Okay, thanks.
I like that. There's so much about the show that's appealing. For instance, being in New York means that anybody who's anybody is available to you, right?
Well, that's true.
And that's a great appeal. And, I mean, and they're not taped, and it has all the spontaneity of a live show. How many bookers do you have on the show?
Well, we have the Gilman, who is the producer, and then we have four associate producers and two production assistants and one secretary.
And I suppose you get a lot of calls from people, too, don't you?
They get calls all day and all night. Those kids work 13 hours a day. They come in around 7 o'clock in the morning for a meeting. Show goes on at 9. And then they're in a meeting from 10:30 to 12, and then they do all their booking in the afternoon.
Now, what kind of hours do you keep, Regis?
Well, my schedule's like this. I get up around 7:30. See, I live in the city.
Yeah, so you're close.
She commutes in every day, but I chose not to do that.
Right.
So I live in the city, and I can sleep in till 7:30. I leave the house around 8:20. I take my daughter to school, and then I cut through Central Park and go to ABC Studios.
Right, from east side to the west, right?
That's the west side, right? And change. About now, I get there around 8:30. I change. Gelman comes up around 8:45. We have 5 minutes of conversation about who's on the show or what's new or what he's seen during whatever he's rehearsed. You see, he'll rehearse. Like tomorrow, we'll have on Dick DiBartolo, who will have some Father's Day gifts ideas on.
Right.
Well, all of those things have to be rehearsed for the camera. I don't do that because I want to be surprised. I want to see it for the first time when the audience sees it. But Gelman's there, so he'll come up and say, "Hey, we got some good stuff," or whatever he has to say, we will say it right then. At 8:50, we go downstairs. He goes out to warm up the audience, and I go into makeup.
Oh, he does the warm-up?
Yeah. Then about 9:50, I go out, say hello, and Joy or Kathy will come out. She'll say hello and get behind the desk, and we're off and running.
You will not have met the guests before?
No. Oh, today I went in and said hello to that Air Force captain.
Right.
He was somebody special. But for the most part, I don't.
Do you know in advance the day before?
Yes, the night before they will send me some notes as who's on tomorrow. For example, tomorrow Ann Gillian is on, and Jane Brody, New York Times, a reporter who has just turned 50. She's a terrific lady, writes for the Health and Science Division.
Yes.
And Dick DiBartolo with Father's Day Gifts. We were supposed to have Bob Hope on tomorrow, but okay. Bob's not feeling so great, so he's going to save his strength for his nighttime appearance.
Right. Yeah, you have a good simpatico. But you have met so many of these people. Are your friends from the Joey Bishop and the San Diego
shows? I've known them more than 20 years now, Milton, so it's easy, you know. And you know what? I have found that sometimes when you talk to a guest before the show, you leave the best part of the interview out there in the hallway.
Right.
It gets out of your mind. You don't remember to ask that same question again, and it's gone.
Now, when do you leave after the show?
Well, then I'm on here for most of the morning. Usually go to lunch around 12:30 and come back here around 1. I finally get out of here around 2.
Oh, you come back again after lunch?
Yeah, we have lunch right around here. There's a couple of nice restaurants right on the west side.
What's that nice Chinese place across from Lincoln Center?
Yeah, I was just Shun
Lee.
Shun Lee.
Yeah, it's very nice.
Yeah, it's an excellent Chinese restaurant. I had lunch in the restaurant opposite that across the street called Spoozy. That's an Italian place.
Are these business or fun lunches?
Well, today I met with Andy Sedaris, who used to direct the ABC college football games. He's won 9 Emmys. He's a great old director. And now he's doing his motion pictures, and he was telling me about his new movie. He's an old pal from Hollywood.
Mm.
Most of them are fun lunches.
We're going to take a little break. I'm here with Regis Philbin. We'll give you a little weather and a commercial or two. Don't forget, the top cops are going to be on at 10 o'clock, but you've got 10 minutes yet to talk to Regis. Meteorologist Chuck Taylor says we'll have a low tonight near 68. Tomorrow, warm with thunderstorms developing, highs near 86. Tomorrow night, scattered thunderstorms, lows in the upper 60s. Wednesday for Louisville, a few showers and thundershowers, highs on Wednesday near 85. It's fair in 79. Milton Metz here with Regis Philbin on our phone-in. Stay tuned.
Jarvis, stop moping. I'll only be gone for a week, big guy. Besides, you'll be staying at Howard O'Neill Boarding and Training Kennel.
Did I see a little doggy smile there?
Yeah, you like Howard O'Neill, don't you? Remember, you stayed there 2 years ago, and you loved the way they treated you. They walked you regularly, indoors and out. They fed you well, groomed you, taught you some doggy manners, and you met a lot of nice friends at Howard O'Neill. Why, you won't even miss me. Oh, come on, Jarvis. Stop laying a guilt trip on me. I can't take you on vacation. You'll have just as much fun at Howard O'Neill. It's like Club Med for dogs. You know, Jarvis, wait a minute. You know, come to think of it, you'll probably have more fun than me. Hey, stop that. Stop that giggling, Jarvis. Jarvis, stop it.
Howard O'Neill Boarding and Training Kennel. Your dog's home away from home, only 5 minutes from the airport. And Howard O'Neill now offers grooming and training for all breeds. They have a wide range of pet food and equipment. Plus, they carry the popular Sandycast dog collection. Sandycast replicas of various breeds from Chinese Chow to German Shepherd. Howard O'Neill Boarding and Training Kennel. 4551 Poplar Level Road, a half block south of Louisville Downs.
Hey, Louisville. You won't believe what's happened now at the Kentucky State Fair and Exposition Center. Your favorite sale just got better. Spiegel catalog fashions have been reduced again. Time for another visit. There's always something new. We restock daily with top name fashions from the exciting Spiegel catalog. And guess what? Now it's all 70% off. 70% off fashions for women. 70% off fashions for men. 70% off casual fashions. 70% off career fashions. The Kentucky State Fair and Exposition Center is packed with top-name summer fashions. All at 70% off the original Spiegel catalog prices. That's 70% off before summer even begins. For a limited time only. Don't miss it, because when it's gone, it's gone.
Prices have been slashed again at the Kentucky State Fair and Exposition Center. Spiegel catalog fashions are now 70% off. They restock daily, so there's always something new. Don't miss it.
Smithfield, Kentucky. Hello, Bradley.
Hello, Mr. Metz.
Greetings to you.
Hello, Regis.
Hi, Bradley. How you doing?
Just fine. I'd like to ask you, on the lighter side of the subject, how you liked your guest from the WWF, like the Bushwhackers or who was the Ultimate Warrior?
Well, you know, Bradley, some people think I'm crazy, but I love those wrestlers.
I do.
I've loved them for years. I think it's the best show on television. And as a matter of fact, they're starting something new now. They're starting the WBF, the World Bodybuilding Federation.
I know.
And I'm going down to Atlantic City this weekend to MC their first bodybuilding championship. So, and Macho Man's going to be there, you know, and the Ultimate Warrior, and all of Milton Metz's very close friends.
I coach them.
And we're going to have some laughs down there. But frankly, I love having them on because they just bring a lot of excitement, and I never know what they're going to do. And
the Bushwhackers.
The Bushwhackers were really screams, weren't they? I mean, they ate all those sardines. they kissed the women in the audience. It was wild.
Yes.
Very good. Thank you, Brad.
Thanks, Bradley.
Thank you.
Glad you liked them.
Thanks.
Irvin, you're on with Regis Philbin.
Hello, Regis.
Hi, Irving.
About a month ago, my wife told me, and we watch you a lot, but she told me about some construction workers that you had modeling, I understand, it just about blew you all away.
Well, you know, that's the building they're putting up next door. That's how I lost my window. And we had Jim Palmer, the old pitcher, on with the jockey shorts. And so we said, well, why don't we do a fashion show? And why don't we, I said to Gelman, why don't we get some construction workers, some real men on there? So we went outside and we picked five of these guys and did a little interview with them out on the sidewalk. And then the next day brought them on and modeling their underwear. And this one little guy, Milton, had a sock hidden in his underwear.
I've heard about that.
And when he came out, he kind of reminded me of you in your heyday. He reached inside his pants there, and I held my breath because I don't know what he was going to do, and he pulled out his sock, and everybody screamed.
My wife liked to die when this all happened, I think.
And they weren't anklets.
I was just walking down the street today with Joy, and I saw the sock man.
Oh, really?
Yeah, he was having his lunch out on the sidewalk there.
Oh,
eating dining al fresco. His nickname is the Sock Man now.
Well, we enjoy your show very much, and we want you to just stay on for as long as you can.
Thanks, Irving. Thanks
okay.
a lot.
Bye.
Regis, I suppose Buena Vista continues getting letters from stations that don't carry you, and their salesmen are out there. What's saturation in the country?
I think it's like 92% from what I have heard.
But there's still more getting onto the syndication, right?
Well, sure, there's still 8% more. You know, it's a funny business, Milton. It depends on the size of the market, and your success depends on what station you're on and what show you follow, and, you know, it's a lot of variables involved.
You're in the major cities, aren't you, all the major markets?
Yeah, I would say we're in all of the major cities, yes.
Would you say this is, you're on the verge of maybe, despite all your past successes, the most gratifying individual success?
Yeah, I would say so, Milton. After many years, this has been my major success, especially nationally. I've always had successful local shows, as you know, but never was able to translate that success nationally until now. And it's really gratifying to know that, you know, all of these folks in Louisville are enjoying what I've always thought they would enjoy and was never really allowed to do before now.
Plus the imprint of your own ideas. That's an extra bonus.
It's very gratifying.
Hello, Jim, you're on.
Yes, I'd like to welcome Regis here, and you really have a real nice, wholesome show there.
Thanks, Jim.
I really enjoy it. And, I don't have anything to do with the with the Foster Brooks tournament, but I'm sure they'd love to have you and Perry come next year and play in it together. I think that would be a plus for the tournament and a plus for the city of Louisville, too.
Well, that's a golf tournament. You know, I did play golf last week with Perry Como, a couple of holes. I hadn't played in about 20 years, and I found I still got my swing, you know?
Well, I'll tell you what, you and I talked about playing tennis. They have a tennis part to...
That's even better.
Yeah, we'd love to. I don't have anything to do with it, but I know that they would welcome you with open arms.
Well, that's very nice. If I hear from them and if we can work it out, I'd love to come down.
Okay. Thanks, Jim.
Thanks, Jim.
Bye-bye. Hello, Bob. You're on.
Yes, I just want to say hello to Regis and that I just got in my car from attending a fundraising dinner and heard you on the air with you, and I called my wife, and she's listening. She never misses any of your programs at all.
Well, that's good, Bob.
I just wanted to get you to say hello to Carol.
Sure.
I appreciate that.
Okay.
Thank you.
Okay. Carol? I guess he's calling. He wouldn't do stop his car, Milton?
he's in a pay station.
Oh, he's at a pay station. Yeah. Well, Carol, I want to say hello to you.
Well, I was in the car to begin with.
Okay.
Bob, sounds like a lot of fun. You're a lucky woman.
Well, she enjoys your show every day.
Well, thanks.
Thank you.
Okay.
Bye.
Oh, listen, I want to congratulate you on the Miss America gig you're getting.
Yeah, that was just announced, and I hope it's going to be okay. I think it'll be, you know, I know it's going to be an experience for us.
The only trouble is, Regis, what if they find you're better looking than the contestant?
I don't think so, Milton.
Let's take one more call.
All right.
Bardstown, hello, Rick.
Hello, Mr. Metz. Hello, Regis. How are you?
Hi, Rick. How you doing?
Just fine, thank you. I want to ask something that I don't think anyone has asked thus far tonight, for those of us that are maybe just a little bit younger than you are, how you got started in show business.
Well, I started as a page at NBC and then went out to Hollywood because I thought all the production was going out there, and worked as a stagehand at a local station in Hollywood, and then wrote the news for the newscaster on that station. Wanted to read my own stuff. Went to radio in San Diego, KSON, out of the U.S. Grand Hotel, and rode around in the car reporting radio news, and then pinch hit for the TV sportscaster, and stayed on TV, and then got my own newscast and talk show in San Diego. And that's basically how it started.
You did it rung by rung, didn't you?
Yeah, it wasn't any overnight success, I'll tell you that.
Rick, thank you very much.
Thanks,
Rick. Good night.
Well, Regis, I can't tell you, you know, after coming off our brief meeting a couple of weeks ago, you're a man of your word, and I appreciate it more than I can say.
Enjoyed being with you. You know, you're an old pro, and I liked being with you there in Louisville. We had a lot of laughs, and if I come down that way again, I'd like to see you again.
Yeah, we'll do
and
that.
When you come to New York, you must come in and sit in and watch our show live.
Wouldn't miss it, and next time you come down, and we'll try to work it out. Bring your racket. We'll hit
it. All right, fine.
Thank you, Regis.
Okay, Milton. Thanks very much.
Great. Bye-bye. Regis Philbin, stay tuned now for the two Chiefs. This is Milton Metz. Stay with us, please.